Hi everyone, how are you? Welcome back to EB Science Virtual Class. I hope all of you are having an amazing day. This is Genrox Education TV, your host for today. For today's video, you will learn about circulatory system. This lesson, you will learn about the parts of circulatory system and its function. And also, you will learn about the importance of the human heart. In some part of this video, you're going to learn and answer some basic questions. But before we start, I would like to ask you a few basic questions. Have you ever experienced that you accidentally cut or sliced your finger with a knife? If yes, what did you see and what did you feel right after you got cuts on your finger? So probably, you might answer that there is a blood. It's painful, right? Blood is one of the basic word or vocabularies that you're going to learn related to circulatory system. Alright? So why is that circulatory important in human body, in all other living organisms? For this topic, you will learn about the basic vocabularies related to circulatory system. See, for example, circulatory. Next, blood. Blood vessels. Blood cells. So these are some examples that you're going to learn step by step. Since we are talking about the word blood, what do you mean by that? Alright, so we see a blood, okay? By the time we accidentally had a cut in our finger. Aside from that, menstruation period for ladies, or there were an accident, blood from the animals, and so on. Alright? So remember, blood is an important component in circulatory system. You might wonder, what is blood made up of? Alright, take note. Blood consists of plasma and blood cells. So what is meant by plasma? Plasma is a pale, yellow, clear liquid containing water and several substances such as enzymes, nutrients, hormones, carbon dioxide, and metabolic waste. Alright, so you got it? Let us remember that blood cells are composed of red blood cells. Okay, what is it again? Red blood cells and white blood cells, including platelets. Okay, so what are those blood cells? These are composed of red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets. Alright, so remember those three words. Now, let us focus about the meaning or the function of circulatory system in our body. So remember, a circulatory system, it is an internal transport system which is needed to deliver useful materials to the body cells and remove the waste materials from them. That means to say that the internal transport system is what we call circulation process. So that's the way how our blood circulates throughout the body with oxygenated blood. So that's how circulatory system plays an important role as useful materials in order to circulate in our body, including the flow of our nutrients. Process of circulation, it is very important that our cells need nutrients, oxygen, and water. So these are all important elements that we need in our body during circulatory process. Meanwhile, carbon dioxide and other waste products produced by the cell must be removed. So that means to say that it's not needed during blood circulation because it blocked, okay, with the other nutrients which is really needed in our body. Alright, so that's the reason why urine, okay, our sweat product, okay, from our skin and all other excretory waste materials which is not needed during blood circulation process. The question is, what are the four basic characteristics of circulatory system? So I'm going to mention all of those. 1. For circulating fluid. I'll repeat, circulating fluid. 2. Pumping device. Pumping device. 3. For blood vessels. Blood vessels. And also last, valves. Valves. So these are four important, okay, basic characteristics of circulatory system which plays an important job when it comes to blood circulation. Okay, do you understand? Now let's talk about the first basic characteristic of circulatory system. So this is what we call circulating fluid. So what is that circulating fluid, by the way? That is our blood, okay? It's a blood in a human body. So blood considered as circulating fluid when it comes to blood circulation. So during blood transports, it is very useful, and those waste materials will be removed, and those other important nutrients and oxygenated blood circulates throughout our body in order to function. Basically, in our own understanding, the color of the blood is red, right? Or reddish. That's correct. So actually, blood consists of different red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets. Okay? So, what are the major functions of those blood cells? Now, let's start from the red blood cells. How can we describe red blood cells? These are circular, flattened by concave disc-shaped cells. So, this is usually produced in our bone marrow. It has a nucleus when it is first formed but loses when it's mature. So it is contained a red pigment called hemoglobin, which is a special kind of iron containing protein. So what is that? Hemoglobin, right? So hemoglobin combines with oxygen molecules and transports to all cells in the body. Okay, you get it. Next one is white blood cells. How can we describe white blood cells and why is that important? All right, so white blood cells are spherical in shape and each have nucleus throughout life. They are formed from bone marrow and spleen cells. Like for example, lymphocytes. It produce a special kind of protein called antibody. Next one we have phagocytes. It destroy germs or foreign particles. That is why sometimes when we are ill or sick, okay, so our body tried to fight, okay? Our immune system tried to fight against sickness or diseases so that we have enough energy every day, right? So we live happy and healthy. Another special blood cells, this is what we call platelets, okay? Platelets. These are membrane-bound fragments of cytoplasm from large cells in bone marrow. They play an important role in the clotting of blood, which makes the bleeding stop, okay, when the blood vessel is cut or broken. Say for example, your hand got cut, okay? So in a few minutes or seconds, once it stopped, it is because there is what we call platelets that used to stop the bleeding of that blood. All right, now let us continue about the four basic characteristics of circulatory system. So we have number two, pumping device. All right, so do you know what particular organs in our body which is considered as pumping device? What do you think? Okay, that is what we call human heart, our heart, right? So what do you think? What is in your own idea when we talk about heart? That is what for? What are the major functions of a human heart? What happens during our heart pumps? Okay, remember, blood is moved through the body by muscular contractions of the heart. Look at it. Right, so probably you say that it's for, it's not right. So heart plays a vital role, okay, in order that our entire human body system works or function. So remember, heart is very important. That is why some people experience heart attack. So their immune system, the entire body felt weak and pale, right? So they need to recover few days, few months, or years, and they need to take healthy medicine or nutritious food in order to recover and have more energy to do. What is heart for, right? So why is it important organ in our body? Okay, remember, heart is a vital organ which lies in the chest, okay? So left portion of your chest. So the size, it's like your fist, okay? So that is what we call the shape of your heart. And that it works like pumping that creates the pressure to drive the flow of our blood to all parts of the body. The exchange of substances takes place and blood flows back to your heart. Okay, so that is the main job of a human heart. And of course, during the breathing activity, there is what we call a gas exchange between oxygen going in to our respiratory organs, right? So that's the time that our hearts responded. So our hearts pumps the blood at the same time because of the exchange of the oxygen or deoxygenated blood that might distribute it throughout the body. So if we breathe normally, right, our hearts pumps normally also. Alright guys, this is the end of the part 1 video related to the topic of circulatory system. So for this part, we talk about blood cells and human heart. So those are basic characteristics on how circulatory system plays an important role in the process of circulation in our body. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I hope you learned something from this. Don't forget to answer your quizzes and your assignment. Please go to the Google Classroom there in the AP website. Thank you so much and good luck. Alright guys, see you in the next video. Remember, stay home, stay safe, enjoy learning.